Big old Stacey, not big, you know what I mean? Hey, my favorite banker at the Grand Exchange.
First things first, get your stick out of my face before I shove it where the sun don't shine.
Oh yeah, sorry about that, Stacey. No, just did the Wildy clapping a few people, you know how it be.
No, I do not know how it be. So anyway, what's this red thing behind you?
Oh yeah, this little guy. Well, basically I was out in the wilderness, just keeping all the monsters at bay, making sure they don't come over the walls and eradicate Gillenor. But I ended up slaying his mum, and he just started following me around after that.
Well, that's a bit cruel, isn't it?
Yeah, I guess. Until they climb over the walls and fucking eat you. Oh, and don't get me started on this
one.
Poor blimey, Stacey. He was a bit of a... To be honest, it was mainly the PKs. He weren't too bad. But now this geezer is actually solid. He's like a loyal servant until the day I die.
Oh, really? Prove it?
Yeah, okay, whatever. So, Timmy, who is the true lord and king of all of the lands, hmm?
That would be your mama.
Ha 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 ha. Oh, I like this guy. Bankroll, how the saying go? Got it flooded to my ankles. Need a raincoat, pair of boots and a dang bow. Gotta stay flow. I might pull up in a stagecoach playing Beethoven.
Didn't think that it would work. Now they coming out the woodwork. So before the wilderness update came out, I had barely ever set foot in here. I literally did not want anything to do with it purely because of PKs. And well, I'm not gonna lie, during my time here, things have changed. I've become a lot more aggressive. My heart rate is no longer now potentially putting me at risk of a heart attack because I've just encountered it so many times that it's now become just a way of life. And I am no longer the prey that shall be served upon for their luscious meals. No, Mr. PKer. I shall take your loot keys and add it towards my 40 blighted restores, whatever your rag gear can afford. You know, that's what I'm saying. That's enough shit talking to PKers. I mean, in all honesty, I'm pretty sure that a lot of the people PKing in the wilderness boss rooms are actually people who don't normally PK and are probably just trying to get, like, used to it, have a little bit of fun with it, and maybe snipe a little bit of juice if they can. Obviously, you get the occasional, like, sweaty PK, but I believe most of them are stuck in the rev caves or actually at the GE PvP world. And anyway, that aside, I think it's time to move on to what the wilderness really did grant me, and that was just a ton of loot. So before I even began this adventure, I had no plan on recording any of the content. I just played RuneScape for the fun of it, but times have now changed. Given my luck here, it's just been absolutely wild. And these clips are going to be going back to the earlier stages of when the wilderness was released. Now, I don't even have my very first few rewards, like, recorded, but my first bit of loot was a Voidwaker gem, which I sold for 275 mil. I got that on the same day of release. And then for the next 5 days, holy smokes, everything you're seeing on screen was within the 5 days, which is why fangs were going for 50 and 40 mil. And I remember, like, I was jumping on just before I went to the gym. I was like, oh, I'll go do some cardio today. I'll quickly do a little trip at the, you know, old Venonatus before I bop off. And then with like 20 minutes in free-for-alls, I'm grabbing these goddamn fangs and they're just making me bonkiosaurus. So I was getting so many drops that my clan chat actually became aggressive towards me whenever I would start getting these things. It would drop into the chat and the entire clan would just be like, yo, stop. Stop, please. You're ruining the market. And I was single-handedly crashing the market for fangs at this point. I couldn't believe what was going on. I felt like every time I went to the Veni, the big old spider boy, that there was going to be a bit of loot waiting for me, a bit of moolah to be made. Now, not only was the uniques making me a ton of cash, but as you can see, 150 Grimmy Snapdragons just added to the banks, like, also. And that combined with Onyx Bolt Tips that just kept rolling in over and over again, their basic loot alongside all of these uniques was just tallying up. My bank was getting a bit filthy, so filthy that I was like, oh my days, I might actually have enough GP to go get these huge upgrades, which I thought I would only be able to get if I went and got myself a shadow from goddamn Toa, which, to be honest, Toa wasn't treating me nicely. I was like 300 hard raids dry at this point. I think I've only got 200 KC, but yeah, that's how I felt. And the fact that I was getting all these uniques now from Wildy bosses, I was like, well, I think I found my new home. This is where GP is to be made and my RNG actually works. So the Wildy had only been out around this point 4 or 5 days, I think, is when the gem started just about dipping under 100 mil. And that's when I got a little bit more interested in the Vetium boss. But I decided to stick at Venny just for a little longer. No way. Oh my god, I actually got it. What is this? What is this RNG? Oh my god. No way. So after getting the pet, I decided to have a look at my collection book, and this is how old Vetium was looking. 824 KC with 4 gems, 5 fangs, and the pet, and only missing the ring. Which, I'm not complaining. Oh, and then there was another fang, which, why not? So with the Venny pet in my pocket and ideally looking up to grab myself a Vetium pet, I made my way over there pretty soon. And I'd done a few kills here and there. I was taking little breaks between Venny to come here. And that's when I pulled my first Void Waker blade. Now, this was still pretty early when the blade was going for a bit of bonk, so pretty happy about that. Ah, yes. But it wasn't much long later that I would find myself continuing to clap Vetian's cheeks to only be rewarded with but another blade. At 150 KC, I could not believe what was happening, but I was absolutely love it. Rolling in beef Wellington, as Gordon Ramsay would say. But this was still at a stage where everything was worth so much more money. Like, compared to today's time, I think the blade, like, it even went down to like 40 mil at some point. It may be around that mark at the moment. But as you will see, this bad boy sold for 824 mil instantly, which was mwah. And I believe the first blade I got around 130, 140 mil. And you can see I have a Void Waker in my inventory, which I actually decided to sell because I thought I would rather just take some items that I can use to speed up my kills because there weren't many PKs at this point. But now we're going to be jumping pretty much like a month in the future, quite a long time later, where at this point I had actually grabbed a couple of skulls from Vetium whilst I wasn't recording because I was just trying to get myself the pet. And well, it was at this time it finally happened. At the big old KC of 761, the Vetium pet found its way into my pockets whilst I was duoing with this pacifist. And by means of the gods, he was but that. He didn't try to attack me as soon as I got some loot, which was very nice. And this was also at a time where I had now become comfortable with anti-PKing, because the leap in time from the last clip of the blade to this stage, it'd pretty much been like a whole month, and I'd got so many more, like KC here. I'd also got some additional at Venonatus as well. I believe my Venonatus KC actually is at 1.7k, and I think I got maybe one more fang, but the majority of my luck for the uniques of these bosses was all within the first week, which is the perfect time to get the RNG to come out and play. So I'm pretty goddamn happy about that. So after all my love in the Wildy, we can check out the collection log and see the finale looking loot. So my current looking log, oh sorry, I don't have 1.7k, 1.5k, I overshot it a bit, but at 1.5k we do have 5 gems. So I did get an additional gem during the KC, I kind of forgot about that. We're up to 7 fangs. I think, to be honest, all my pickaxes were actually from Vetian, but I did get my treasonous ring in quite a funny way. I got PK'd at Vetian, and I ran into the Venonatus lair, and there was no one there, so I decided just to pick up a kill whilst I was there, and it was the treasonous ring to complete my log, so that was pretty goddamn funky. And the classic pet, which was like, you know, halfway through this KC. So at Vetium, I do actually have 3 blades. I didn't record one of them. It was during an event with my clan where we needed to get ourselves a dragon pickaxe. I pulled myself another Void Waker blade, which went for around 40 or 50 mil. Also, since then, I've had 3 Vetian skulls. One of them was in my first video where I was locked out of my bank and I had to make 3 million GP before I got deleted by the rogue banker Stacy. But yeah, we've had a couple more since then as well. And I believe pretty much all of these have been from Vetian himself. Callisto, yes. So You're like, okay, that kind of makes sense that you would already have these loots, but yeah, the Voidwaker Hill was in a mass with my clan. I say a mass, so there was like 6 of us, I think, and that was pretty funky because we had like a couple low levels with us that came along for a laugh, and we then got this split Voidwaker Hill in my name, and everyone got like a nice 16 mil pop each. That was pretty awesome. And then when I went to go test out RTO, because I'm obviously trying to get the pet, I managed to pull myself some Claws of Callisto as well. That wasn't too long ago, and that gave me like an extra 13 mil, along with Dragon 2 H's being a lot across the board with all of them. So yeah, pretty much the last pet I need, Callisto Cub, so I'm trying to get adjusted with the RTO. He's a bit of a pain. So that's probably going to be another video within itself, but ladies and gentlemen, the absolute luck. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, enough rambling, have a wonderful day, and yeah, I'll see you around.